Well, I shall marry the princess on Friday week. That'll be all, Now, will you listen to me?
No, you listen to me. For every man who's born today, a dozen females flourish. Just think of all the women in this palace. Your Majesty is far too kind, and really should not nourish such serpents in your bosom.
My dear, you're callous. Now, why distrust this sweet young thing? You're so suspicious, aren't you?
And you are so easily beguiled. I'm frightened she'll enchant you.
Well.
And you have too many ladies, all soignées and perfectly gone.
Too many women, but not enough love to go wrong.
But you're going to marry, sir.
Back home I'll have to dodge.
No more little suppers for two.
At my hunting lodge.
Too many kisses.
But all that is over at last.
Soon you'll discover you cannot get rid of your past.
Now why bring that up?
It won't be very long before the queen has also found that there are too many women.
But plenty of love to go wrong. Oh, my dear, everyone says the princess is perfectly charming. I was rather hoping you'd be the best of friends, both of
us. Really?
Yeah.
How delightful.
Oh, that's what I thought.
You know, Chris, this is very touching. Oh. I think I'm going to cry.
My dear. Brute.
Perhaps your Majesty would like me to act as chief bridesmaid at the wedding?
We should be delighted to see you at the wedding if you care to come.
Shall I tell you what I'll do at the wedding, my little king?
What'll you do at the wedding, my little countess?
I shall walk up the aisle and tell the congregation that you like a soft-boiled egg for your breakfast. That will make the party go.
Will you stop that row?
No, don't be cross, Chris.
I'm not cross and I'm not Chris. But will you listen to me just once? I want you to be friends with the princess. She's very musical. She's most anxious to hear you play her grand piano.
Really? But not half as anxious as you are to see me play her second fiddle.
See that, Ernest?
Yes, sir.